Alrighty, welcome to a standard video here on Magic Arena. I'm going to be playing with a companion today, Gigan Cyberclaw Terror, otherwise known as Gyruda, Doom of Depths. It makes your deck be all even cost cards, but for that you get a 6-mana 6/6, mills both players for 4, then chooses one of those 8 cards. That's a creature card, and that has an even cost, and puts it into play. The combo here, and this I got this deck straight from Huey's stream, twitch.tv/HueyWJ, if you wanted to know, with 12 2-drop accelerants, 3 migration paths, so to try to get you to 6 as soon as possible. And then you play Gyruda, and you hit Thassa ideally, because that'll end of turn give you another trigger, but also Kogla, the Titan Ape, Dream Eater to bounce their stuff, Spark Double, which lets you get another trigger as well, while remaining in play, because it's not legendary. And then an end raise forward is to eventually kill them. Your sideboard's also all even cost cards. And the net result is you got a very consistent ramp deck that always has its payoff. Let's see how this does. Alrighty, I would like to play first. And, well, can easily mulligan this hand. Whereas this hand sounds great. I'm going to keep 6. I'm going to put end raise forerunners back. And get things started. My opponent also mulliganed. And let's run out that Fabled Passage. Also, am I gold? Nice. Last time I made a video on Arena, people made fun of me because I was only bronze. But now, I'm the mighty gold rank. And I guess that means I'm great. I don't know. Let's see. Let's hope to draw some lands, shall we? Gruul Guildgate. All right, well, let's just go Paradise Druid here. And then next turn, hopefully we can Double Growth Spiral. And as long as we hit some lands, we can have a turn 4 Gyruda. All right. Play a land, and then let's just pass the turn. Hello. Hello, indeed. So now I do need this Paradise Druid to live. I suppose I could technically draw 2 lands off of the Growth Spirals and my between the Growth Spirals and my turn, in which case I would be able to play Gyruda, Gigan, Cyberclaw Terror. This card's sweet. All right. They're going to Growth Spiral, sure. I guess they had to tap Paradise Druid, that makes sense. And they're just going to pass the turn. I'm worried about Bone Crusher killing my Paradise Druid. But, okay, good. In that case, all is well. And we get to Growth Spiral here. Enters tapped, sure. Because now it doesn't matter. Because even if they kill... actually, I guess it does matter, but it's really hard for them to have a 1-mana kill spell. All right, well... Then again, it didn't matter. All right, let's see what we hit here. Mill 4. So we milled, well, a Fibblethip. All right, well, not the most powerful thing in the world, but you know what? I'll take it. I also end up with a 6-6 in play, so that's pretty nice. And then next turn, I guess I wish I'd, the way this had panned out, I wish I'd kept the End Raise Forerunners. But next turn, I can play Kogla, Titan Ape, and nug one of their creatures if, I guess if the Paradise Druids aren't tapped, I can't fight, but presumably they're going to play something here. All right, they're ramping hard, but they don't have a companion, so what are they ramping to? I don't know, but they're not putting anything into play. Would like to draw Thassa or Spark Double here, but that's fine. All right, so 3, 6, 6 mana, 7, down to 6. So I can attack with these. I guess I should have fought... Kogla on the Leafkin first, because I'm going to do that anyway, but whatever. Alright, let's crack this. It's just another forest. The funny thing is I hit on the pretty low end of what I can hit with Gyruda here, and I still feel like I'm in pretty good shape. Okay. They're at 11, and they're facing down a 7-6, a 6-6, and some dorks, plus I have access to lots of mana, and this deck has some kind of expensive cards in it, so at some point I'm going to find something. Drakuseth, Maw of Flame. Oh, Spark Devil? They're at 11? Okay, so now I can just Spark Devil, copy Kogla, fight that, and then attack them. All right, game 2. I'm going to assume Aether Gust is going to be good here, and... I guess I could take out like 2 Fibblethips. End Raise Forerunners might not be what I want because it looks like they're trying to combo me out too. Destiny Spinner's nice against counter spells, but I guess I could put in a couple Destiny Spinners. Yeah, let's just wait to see what their deck looks like before we decide to do that. All right, time for game two here. Let's see what we got going on. This hand looks good to me. It's not the best hand in the world, but I've got a Paradise Druid, so I've got a piece of ramp. It's pretty hard for this deck to not to keep a hand without any ramp. Just because if you don't play a ramp spell on turn two, whether it's Paradise Druid, Growth Spiral, or Wolf Willow, I think you end up in a pretty rough spot. It just ends up being pretty slow. But I think any ramp spell that you keep is, or any hand with a ramp spell that you keep is probably good. It's really hard for this deck to get flooded. It's hard. If it misses six mana, it doesn't do much, but a hand of all ramp spells is still pretty good because you guaranteed have your bomb six drop. Let's just play the Druid again here. And now we drew that Growth Spiral, which is pretty nice because that's the second piece of ramp to try to get us here. Why are they playing a bunch of Guild Gates? They have Circuitous Routes or something. Okay, here comes Leafkin Druid. Let's just lead with Growth Spiral here. See what they do. If they've got Aether Gust, they've got Aether Gust, I suppose. Okay. I don't really want to draw a Growth Spiral at this point. And then now I'll play Breeding Pool and play Fibbleth up here. I said I didn't really want to draw a Growth Spiral. Well, I did anyway, funnily enough. Because now that they've disrupted me, it's gonna be an extra turn anyway. So it doesn't really speed me up to do that. My Paradise Druid's tapped, so I guess drawing the Growth Spiral after all that is okay. Because now they can kill the Paradise Druid. And then next turn, I'm just going to go Fibblethip plus Growth Spiral. And I'm going to draw a lot of cards. All I need to do is find another land, and then I can have a turn 5 Gyruda. Hopefully they don't do too much to mess with that here. They do have 5 mana. They can play like a Cavalier. No, I guess they can't play a Cavalier of Thorns with the mana situation right now. Ghidorah, King of the Cosmos. So they could have mutated. Oh, they didn't have enough mana to mutate. I see. Okay, so play a land. Play Growth Spiral. Put another land into play. And then I think it's worth playing Fibblethip here. Even though it's going to cause me to lose a Fibblethip to Legend Rule. I could attack first, but I have enough respect for the game that I'm not going to do that. And, I even get to play another Growth Spiral. I can wait on that. There's actually an argument for not playing Growth Spiral here, which is my Paradise Druid has Hexproof, and if I tap it, it will not. So this is Iluna, Apex of Wishes. All right. Gem Razor. So they're going to mutate onto... Oh, they're just casting their thing. Okay. Curious they didn't mutate there. But if they're going to pass now, it's pretty free to play Growth Spiral. All right, well, I've got a lot of Gyrudas here. Let's see. Let's play the one they know about here. All right, what do we flip? We missed, but we did not miss on their side. I'll just take out their Ghidorah here. And this seems more than fine. Whew. I played a 6-mana 6-6 that killed their giant 6-6. Also, if they attack with Gem Razor, I'm snap blocking. I don't care if this thing dies. I'm probably going to Legend Rule it. Oh, nope. They've had enough. And match one goes to Gyruda. All right. I'd like to play first. And yeah, this is one of those hands without a ramp spell. I think I can just mulligan. When you always have your payoff, it's a lot easier to mulligan here. Now I'm going to keep this and I'm going to ship back. I think I'll just ship back Fibblethip. I think keeping this many lands plus... Gyruda is probably fine. I know that it's like the backup one, but sometimes you will play against counter spells and they will counter your stuff. Alright, Fervent Champ. Let's see how this goes, shall we? I would love to find another ramp spell here, whether it's Migration Path or Growth Spiral or Paradise Druid, Wolf Willow, any of those things. Also, I realized in between rounds I am still bronze, so I was bragging for nothing. Poor bronze players just like me. Alright, let's take it. Draw. Oh, there we go. There's the money. And then no way we're tapping this Paradise Druid. We're going to take another three this turn, maybe more if they have some other haster. And also, thanks to my strategic mulligans, I don't even have to... I don't even give them a card to rob off Robber of the Rich. All right, let's get our forest here. Let's take our medicine. And then we're going to play Gyruda and see if this works. I would have liked to flip the Thassa. All right, I haven't really flipped much off my side, and this is a matchup where I kind of need to. Oh, there we go. No. We are going to take Dream Eater, and we are going to surveil all of these to the bottom, or to the graveyard. And we are also going to bounce that Annex here. Whew. Yeah. That was pretty good. I get a 6-6 and a 4-3, and it bounced their Annex. And now if their next play is to just replay Annex, or even play Torbran, that isn't, can't possibly be good enough. Next turn I get to play Thassa and start blinking. Oh man, you got another Annex here. Ooh, let's play Fibblethip too, because why not? Plus Thassa's going to be active here, which is pretty nice too. Land. I'm just going to whack them. If they want to double block my Gyruda, I would be fine with that. All right, let's play Thassa, and then end of turn, we're going to blink for the max value here. My 6-6 comes back, mills for 4. Oh, what's that? Is that Kogla Titan Ape? Well, we'll take that, and let's bash their Annex. Like, yeah, it gives them 2 tokens, but this is a lot less scary for Embercleave now. Because that's like the only card I could possibly in a million years lose to. Look at how much power I have on the board. I have a 6-6, a 6-5, a 7-6, and a 4-3 flyer that's bashing them. Oh, look, they're playing Fervent Champion. I don't even need to play the last copy of Gyruda in my hand. Oof, this card is a doozy. All right, they're going to make some attacks here. So I guess I'd rather block the first strikers with Thassa. So best case scenario, they have Embercleave. I mean, maybe they have Infuriate plus Embercleave. I guess I have to watch out for that. Yeah, and then we'll block. Yeah, sure, why not? We'll throw everything. I put the big creatures on their bigger creatures, and I put my small creatures on their small creatures. And okay, they've got Zcleave. They can kill my... Yep, they're going to trade for Gyruda. Aren't they just dead on the backswing here? They've got to have something. I guess technically no, because my Thassa is going to go... Actually, no, technically yes, because I still have Kogla. So I still have Lethal in play, and that does it. All right, game one goes to me, and then I'm going to definitely put in some Gusts, and definitely take out... I don't need Enry's Forerunners for sure. What else do I want to take out? The Fibblethips... Also, I mean, the Fibblethips are just like almost like placeholders there, where I have Fibblethip in there as a way to get extra value off Thassa or play a little cantrip cycler because you want 2 drops that, you know, get you to more ramp or good to blink with Thassa or even bring back with Gyruda if you're desperate. But once I get to have Gusts as an early play instead, I think I'd rather just have those. I could see Kogla coming out too, potentially. Yeah, we're going to mulligan this hand. It don't work. Yeah, we'll keep this and get Kogla out of here. 6 drops that aren't Gyruda are just not that high priority. This hand's a little rough on the draw. I'm going to need to get some help here. I mean, the Gusts are nice, but Growth Spiral is a great ramp spell until you start missing land drops. Then it becomes a lot less effective. So in an ideal world, what I do here is, oh no, I got robbed. What'd they get? In an ideal world, I get to Growth Spiral. Oh, they got their own Gyruda. And hit land drops. All right. I'm just going to... Yeah, I'm going to pass. And my plan is to Growth Spiral and hopefully hit some land drops here. Let's see what they get. They robbed a land. Okay, well, I guess I should have cast in response. I got a 13. Because if I Growth Spiral and then on my turn draw another land or Fibblethip into a land, yeah, like I could Gust that. I just don't think that that's very productive. I really need to be in a spot where I'm playing multiple spells in the same turn. All right, well, yeah, this isn't it. All right, we're super dead. I can spend a turn playing a card and then just fall too far behind what they're doing. I actually wonder if maybe instead of Kogla, I could put in a couple Destiny Spinners. It actually seems like Destiny Spinner might be more what I want here. Instead of Fibblethips, so we'll try those instead. Fibblethip just doesn't really block anything effectively, and Destiny Spinner, they at least have to spend some time or burn on it. All right, I would like to play first. There's no lands in this hand. Okay, I'm in for this hand. I don't have any, I don't have any ramp spells, but I think this hand's got to be better than five, and I can just put back Dream Eater, because, again, I already have a six drop, and then I go turn two Destiny Spinner, turn three Destiny Spinner, or Aether Gust, and hopefully that tides me over. The card I most want to draw in this hand, I think, is the Migration Path, because being able to go from four to six is critical, especially since I kept a hand of three land and three non-ramp cards. So I really only have three mana sources. I need to critically hit my six. Okay, I don't hate Growth Spiral, but we're definitely, especially since we don't have a guaranteed other drops, playing the Spinner. Plus, if I draw another land, I can next turn Growth Spiral plus another Destiny Spinner. And they don't have too many things that can trade favorably here. Land would be really good. Okay. We might have to take a little damage here. Oh, there's the Migration Path. Yeah, I'm going to pay the two life. And I'm going to play Fabled Passage. And I guess I'll get an island here. And I think I'm actually just going to pass the turn. And my plan now is to Gust the Steamkin once they've started playing spells into it. And then next turn play Migration Path. I mean, we'll see. If they play an Anax or something, I guess if they play Anax as their only spell, do I care too much? Yeah, I would still probably rather Gust the Steamkin. Okay. I have three cards. They have three cards. Sure. They attack with Steamkin here. Oh, really? Attack with Scorch Spitter. So they're saying they have Shock, and they want to shock my Destiny Spinner. I think that's fine. Because they lose they have Light Up the Stage. I see. And they've already played their land, so I guess that's fine too. And they hit Bone Crush. Oh, Rimrock Knight. All right, well, I'm going to Gust their Steamkin here. I could have Gusted it in response to the Light Up Stage, I guess, but I don't know. Yeah, I guess it didn't really matter too much. All right, let's just cast Migration Path. Mm-hmm. And the fact that I still have a Destiny Spinner here is really good, because now, what's the best they can do this turn? They're going to play land, Steamkin, and then maybe play it, just cast a Rimrock Knight as a 3-1, and then I'm going to slam Gyruda, and we're going to see where the board goes from there. Plus, worst comes to worst, I might mill something of theirs. All right. Kaboom. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, there we go. This deck's so sick. Spark Double, copying that. This is just ridiculous. Like, how is this a thing we get to do? Oh, look what I've hit. Another Spark Double. All right, Spark Double. It doesn't matter what I copy, I don't think. And let's see, what did they hit? I can get a Steamkin. And I kind of bricked. I guess I just got a Paradise Druid. No attackers. Look, I paid 6 mana in a card that, you know, that I draw every game, that automatically essentially starts my opening hand, but they can't discard it, that'd be too easy. And I got 22 power and 21 toughness off of that. Yeah, okay, they can play a Robber of the Rich, that resolves. They're even going to get the third counter on their Steamkin. Whatever shall I do? Let's bash with these things, I guess. They have to block at least one of them. And then definitely some will survive, and I'll get to play Thassa and Blink, and then get to go from there, I guess. All right, so I think I'm just going to play another Destiny Spinner and play a Thassa here. Also, this deck just activates Thassa very easily. Like, Thassa's frequently going to be live. And then I'm going to pass and Blink Spark Double here. And copy this, and let's see what we mill. We milled only a Thassa from my graveyard, so I guess I'll just put a Runaway Steamkin from theirs. I mean, that wasn't the best in the world, I guess, but like, how are they possibly going to win? I have six 13, 14, 19, 20 toughness right now, so it's going to be pretty hard to get an Embercleave going. The attack with everything? Sure, so let's see. They get to hit. They snagged a Dream Eater and a Spark Double. Block, 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 block. Block, sure. And whatever it is, like, what's the best they can do? The best they can do is Embercleave up the Runaway Steamkin and deal 5 damage to me and not kill my Thassa. Okay, I guess that plays. And then they lose all their cards. And I think I have lethal here. Boom. And that's round two. Let's do one more round to see what this deck is capable of, though. You've kind of already seen that. Alrighty, time for round three. We're going to be on the draw here. Let's see what we are up against. I've got my companion sleeved and ready to go. And my opponent... My opponent's off it. Okay. I guess here we go. This is how we rank up. Oh yeah, bronze tier 3. Ranked up. Let's... We're all the way to bronze tier 2. Let's go one more time. All right, we're on the draw, and I'm certainly going to mulligan this hand. Had one of these been a 2-drop accelerant, sure, but I... Oof, this hand's bad too. Okay, I'll keep this, and I'll put back a Fibblethip and a Dream Eater. I could put back Fibblethip and Spark Double, but I think I'm okay to keep one of the Spark Doubles here. Basically, we're going to bin anything that wasn't a land at that point with the temple here. Playing against Gruul would have been my guess. Ooh, another Pelt Collector. This is where their very fast draws start. So what am I hoping to draw next turn? Probably just like a basic would be nice. Well, temple's actually fine because now I get to Growth Spiral into temple. This is going to be a close game. I mean, it's going to be a close game, but only because I mulled a 5 and I'm on the draw. Otherwise, it would probably not. If either of those things weren't true, it probably wouldn't be a close game. But the mulling to 5 part actually didn't affect me very much, I don't feel like. Like, sure, I had to put back a Fibblethip that maybe I'd have cycled, but I don't even care about the Dream Eater. And I still have enough ramp spells here that I'm going to be in okay shape. All right, let's just Growth Spiral. I still do want to draw lands here. All right, Temple, find me a land. Let's see. Beggars can't be choosers, I don't think. Especially since now what I can do is I go to 13 here, but they don't have another play. And then on my turn, I go Wolf Willow Haven, one of my lands. Play Fibblethip, play a tapped Breeding Pool. And I just have to draw an untapped land next turn to play turn 4 Gyruda. Yeah. My opponent's tanking here. What's going on? You can't cast anything for one red mana. Yeah, that's what I thought. Let's go Wolf. That's not what I want. Wolf Willow Haven. Target that. Auto pay. Yeah. You get me, auto pay. So do they have like a Rimrock Knight in hand? Like what's going on? What's causing all these triggers? Or are they just playing in full control for who knows what reason? Okay, they had Shock. Ooh, they shuffled in, and I hope I don't draw Fibblethip. All right, Breeding Pool tap. So if they have a creature, I guess worst case they have like a Questing Beast. Then I'm probably dead. Paradise Druid put me to 7. If they don't have a 3-power creature, okay. What's going on? Is there like a Convoke? I don't really know what's happening, but I don't really have a choice but to play this. Okay. My graveyard... I'm going to get Thassa, and then end of turn, I'm going to blink it again. Here's where I would kind of like to hit something. Okay. Well, we didn't really get there. We'll put a Fibblethip into play, though. So now we're in a spot. We're at 11. Yeah, we're still doing fine here. We're not dying to Embercleave. We're not dying to Gruul Spellbreaker. Like, yeah, they didn't even haste it. So them not hasting it is basically me winning, I think. Yeah, they have no cards in hand. I'm one mana short of really going off here, but I still get to spark double and copy Gyruda here, and then mill. So my graveyard, I'm just gonna put a questing beast into play, and then I'm gonna attack with, I'm fine attacking with the questing beast, definitely attacking with Thassa, definitely attacking with that, yeah. Ooh, if they're trading off here, that works for me. Because they, yeah, their other pelt collector is going to grow, I guess, but I don't really care if I end up losing. This is going to work out just fine. We're going to trade off a bunch of stuff. They're going to end up with no board, except for a now, like, 4-4 questing or pelt collector, I guess, and then I'm going to get to blink. Oh, I guess blinking that is less good. Sure. I don't actually have the OG in play anymore. all right, well, that's fine. You live, you learn. Actually, you know what? I'll just take it. I'll go to 7. Look, I get to play another Gyruda here. And now I can copy the Spark Double in the way that I really want to. All right, here we go. Here we go. Let's pick up Spark Double, copy. I mean, this is ridiculous. You got to admit, this is ridiculous. Let's just get a Paradise Druid, I guess. Play a Temple of Mystery. And then send in, not for lethal here, but then end of turn, Thassa is going to blink the Fibble Thip that's really a Spark Double. And then I'm going to end up with another 7-7 in play. And, oh, look. Let's just get Kogla and fight. well, you know, they had a good run, but I think we got them. The one attack they missed would have put us a little bit lower, but it turns out it would not have killed us. And now we get to go to game 2 and side in some Aether Gusts. I don't think that Fibble Thip is really where I want to be. And Destiny Spinner seems a little too slow, so this seems fine to me. All right, let's see how game 2 goes here. We've got hopefully some action. And my opponent choosing whether to play first. So here, I've got the turn 2 Wolfalo Haven, but I don't have anything past that. I think I can mull. This I will keep, even though this is not not a hand with a turn 2 ramp spell. First of all, I'm on the draw end of Temple to look for it. And second, I've got a Migration Path, which means if I do find the ramp spell, it's worth quite a bit. So let's go. Temple. Any growth spirals. Oh, Paradise Druid. That works for me. Now I'm going to go turn 2 Paradise Druid, turn 3 Migration Path. And the cool thing is, even if they kill my Paradise Druid after I've cast Migration Path, I'll still have a turn 4 Gyruda here. They cannot stop me. 2-2 Haste. Swinging for the fences. All right. And they shock turn 1, which makes me think they have, well, shock. So I got to keep that in mind. But again, I don't really care if they kill my Paradise Druid after I cast Migration Path. I will not be blocking your Xur'tah Goblin, though. That will not be happening. And what are they going to play? Like a Gruul Spellbreaker or something? Oh, Domri, Anarch of Bolas, and ticking up. Though playing that post-combat did mean that they got one less damage in, though maybe they didn't want me to block, I'm not sure. Alright, so it's Migration Path. This is the path. And I guess I took two off Breeding Pool, and I'll take two off my other Breeding Pool. Plus 3, so I might go to 9 here. 7 if, or 4 if they have a Requesting Beast. Oh, they didn't get to attack with the Shifting Ceratops. Though Shifting Ceratops, I mean, that's a pretty substantial threat against me. I'm going to play Gyruda here. Well, good thing I've got Kogla. Let's see. I think I'm not going to get greedy here. I'm just going to kill the trade for the Shifting Ceratops and keep going like this way. I just think getting them having a Shifting Ceratops in play is a lot more threatening than anything else. Yes, I get to copy. I guess I could have spark doubled it, but this is the same thing, basically, or a little better even. Okay, there goes their Shifting Ceratops. So 3-6-7 mana. I guess I guess I can play Fibblethip, and if I draw a land, I can play Wolf Willow Haven as well. I don't know that actually it's worth me playing, because I'm definitely going to play Thassa. I guess I'll tap Breeding Pool, and then there's no point in attacking because there's Shifting Ceratops. I'm going to copy here. I've got a Paradise Druid to chump. This could be a little rough. Okay, that works nice. There's a Questing Beast and a Spark Double. I actually think I'm just going to pull out Questing Beast, because that way if they want to fight my Questing Beast with something, then it'll take it down. Okay. It says 10-6 Trample. That's good, but I'm glad I didn't get... Oh, no. Okay, they're going to fight there. Yeah, that's fine. And if they want to trade off here, then that works too. And then Thassa Fibblethip might be what I have to end up doing. Okay, well, I'm certainly going to block with Questing Beast. The question is, do I take... Yeah, I'll just take the rest. This will put me to 3. I'm not dead to Shock, at least. Dream Eater. Okay, that one's kind of nice. So let's go... Let's see. 3-6, so I guess I could Wolf Willow Haven the forest here first. Then play a Dream Eater. And I'm going to bounce... I guess I would rather draw Spark Double first. That's fine. And then we're going to bounce the Xur'Tog Goblin? Yeah. Okay, we're going to bounce the Xur'Tog Goblin and then all attack Domri. Yeah, and then we're going to use Thassa end of turn to untap Fibblethip and draw a card. Okay, if I can survive this turn, I feel like I'm in pretty good shape. Because Domri can't fight right now. They don't have that much mana. And then next turn I'll have Gusts, and that'll stop any future Shifting Ceratops shenanigans. If they have double burn spell or something, then yeah, I lose. Looks like they probably do here. Okay. All right. We are going to go to game 3. Shifting Ceratops did a little work that makes me want Endray's Forerunners just as a card I can hit. Since that'll give me a little bit more interaction and take out a Fibblethip. All right, I would like to play first. No, we're going to mulligan this one. Oh, we will keep this one. This one's an actively great hand. I do need to find a land at some point here, but I have a lot of looks at it. Clearly putting back a Migration Path, since the second one's worth a lot less. All right. Whoop, not keeping that. So next turn, I guess I'm just going to play Wolf Willow Haven. That'll give me more outs. Okay. Yeah, so if I draw a land next turn, I'm set, and I think I basically can't lose. If I miss on lands next turn, it's a little more interesting. Let's go Wolf Willow Haven there. And I think I can just pass. And I either am going to go end of turn Growth Spiral, or if they just play like a Ceratops or Questing Beast, Clothie's God of Destiny? Okay, I don't think I care about that. This gives me the opportunity to cast my Growth Spiral here. Because if I spike two lands in a row, I get to still just play Gyruda here. Okay, didn't get there. Now, what's the best they can do? This has 7. And they have 3. They have to play 4 Devotion. I'm just going to play Migration Path here. And then get Island and Forest. Pass the turn. Maybe I should have gusted the Clothies, because now I'm going to take 2 damage from it. I guess they can shock me end of turn as well. I don't really think shock is the... I don't know what their deck looks like post-board, but shock is not the strongest card against me. It just doesn't kill anything. Though I did get double shot to death last game, so maybe I should watch my mouth. Here comes Questing BZ. Yeah, I'm going to take it. All right. So now, kind of an interesting spot. I could play Gyruda here, but I actually feel like it's better to go questing. I could play Spark Double and leave up Gust. I'm at 8. Yeah, that's got to be better. So let's go Spark. Oh, this is that you control. Oof. Not the best play, I'm going to say. That was not really where I wanted to go. Now I think I'm actually going to lose, even though I really didn't have a good reason to do so. All right, let's put your Questing Beast back. If I could have copied Questing Beast, that play would have made sense. Now I'm just going to die to Paradise Druid for basically no reason. All right, well, you know, like when you play... Look, you'd be surprised at the plays people would make in Bronze, including playing Spark Double and having it immediately die. That was a beat. That was a good learning moment. Let's play one more before we wrap it up. All right, we're on the draw. I will keep this hand. Yeah, I definitely threw away what seemed like a very good matchup last game. So let's try not to do that again, shall we? Let's play our Gyruda Doom of Depths for profit. All right, Hero of Precinct 1. I think we're going to do slightly more powerful things, but we'll find out. There's no way to know. So I'm going to go Growth Spiral into land, into Wolf Willow Haven, and maybe something else next turn. Obviously, if I draw a Migration Path, that'd be cool. General's Enforcer. All right. Things spiral out of control. Land. Untap land. So now, I really wish I could have played... played Thassa this turn, but I guess there's no real way for me to do that, is there? Because next turn I'm going to play Gyruda here. It's coming. It's coming for you. I'm going to take 5 this turn, and then they're going to get to make one more play. Maybe they play, if they play General Kudrow. All right. This will be close. I'm going to take 8 this turn. I'm going to go 10, and then I'm going to have to hit something nice off of Gyruda here. In order to stabilize this board. No, I guess it's better to just Fabled Passage crack. Get a blue here, I guess. It doesn't really matter. All right. Womp womp. Here we go. Cogla would probably be the best thing to hit, though I guess Spark Double is always where you want to start. So let's go see what they've got. Was that a Thassa? There's Cheville. All right, well, I'm going to take Thassa. That'll give me another bite at the apple here. And end of turn. This takes 2 mana to sack and sack 2 humans to kill something. That's a pretty powerful card, though. I mean, General Kudrow does some good work. Pumping the whole team, making a hero a token off that, and then you can start killing things. Oh, there's the Spark Double. The only shame is that there's 2 Spark Doubles, so I'm reducing the odds that I hit another Spark Double here. Oh, there's an Enraised Forerunners. All right, well, I'll take that. It won't. So this doesn't kill them right now because it's my end step. I can't attack or anything like that. But the cool thing is if I draw another Spark Double, it can go off here. Also, I just put, 13, 19, 26 power into play while my hand was all ramp spells. Yeah, I would say this is somewhat ridiculous. So I guess if they kill my Spark Double here, Thassa, or kill actually Gyruda, Thassa no longer becomes a creature, and then maybe they can get some attacks in. But then I still have a pair of 7/7s, so they can kill 2 of them, but they also have to sack 4 humans if they do that. So it's not like it's free to just kill things. Sacking 2 of them to kill the original is pretty good, because then Spark Double can't do the thing, but I think that this is gonna work out fairly well. I'm at 10. This is indestructible right now, for whatever that's worth. All right, so they're gonna sack. They're gonna kill the Spark Double. Sure, Spark Double down, and then they're gonna Dire Tactics. Oh, I see. Okay, exile that. And exile cards in my graveyard. I don't care about that, though. And now I have an Enraised Forerunners, though, so they can attack me. They can basically throw away a General's Enforcer to deal some damage. Oh, that was a good draw. Let's see, 3-6, so I guess I can't really do anything else, but I'll play this. Okay, boop, boop. Oh, there we go. There's the money. So let's go Dream Eater. Let's put all these in the graveyard off my Surveil. And then I'm going to bounce with Dream Eater. Their General Kudrow, I think, is clearly the bounce. And then now I'm just going to attack with these two. I mean, Enraised Forerunners has Vigilance, so clearly I'm going to attack. And I'm certainly going to attack with Thassa, because that's the one that is less likely to be able to block on my turn. And end of turn? I didn't come here to not bounce my Gyruda. I could have bounced Dream Eater and locked in some value, but oh yeah, like this is just Spark Double copy. Ooh. Look, you know what? Getting Kogla might be correct, but again, I didn't come here to copy Kogla. I came here to copy. So let's see. I missed. How unlucky. Let's just take the card that does maybe something. Who knows? how many cards do I have left? 14. I guess I should maybe watch out a little, but nah. And then on that next turn, they were just Mega Dead, of course. Yeah, humans, huh? I will submit my deck. All right, we're on the draw with double ramp, so we're keeping this one. And I think my opponent Mulligan there. But I couldn't tell you because, you know, bronze level players, we don't really understand how that all works. I'm speaking only for myself, of course. I did make some real bronze plays last match, though. So, all right. Let's scry. Yeah, we'll scry me a river here. Good podcast, by the way. If you haven't listened to Scry Me a River by Dennis Straniak and Riley, it is a very fun podcast. All right, let's play Paradise Druid. This game's just not going to be even remotely close to being close. And my opponent agrees. Gyruda Doom of Depths, huh? Check back on ChannelFireball.com to take a look at updates to this deck. Because I'm sure there are some things you could do. But, wow, the base strategy of just playing a bunch of ramp and playing a 6-drop companion that's really powerful with Spark Doubles and Thassas seems really good. I would say the Fibble Thips maybe not necessary, not sure. You certainly don't need 4 necessarily. And the sideboard, I'm sure, could use some work. But great, great starting point. Again, Huey brewed this up, got it from his stream. And hope you enjoyed. As always, check back for channelfireball.com for sweet articles and videos. Videos are always free. And then we've got a lot of really high quality articles that we're using CFB Pro to make more content and better content. So thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.